Hey guys, welcome back. Today we are talking about print and cut, but more specifically, we are talking about the barcode feature in Silhouette Studio for print and cut. Now this feature is only available if you're running the auto sheet feeder or if you have the business edition upgrade to the software. Now for the business edition upgrade, I highly recommend it. It is typically $99 on the Silhouette America website, but sometimes they run a sale and you can get it half off. Either way, it is totally worth the one-time fee. With the business edition, you can save your files as SVGs, JPEGs, PNGs. You can use the barcode feature in the print and cut. I'm going to tell you why that's so awesome in just a minute. And you also get upgraded features on the rhinestone panel. The list really goes on and on. Highly recommend it. I am not affiliated with Silhouette America. I'm not pushing any agenda here. I just think that it is a good deal. Now, I personally do not have the auto feeder. It is next on my shopping list, I promise. And when I get that in, I will definitely show you how that works as well. But for today, we're going to run this barcode thing in the business edition, and I am going to show you exactly how it works. Now, my regular printer is out in the home office area. I have my office, and then we have a general home office, and it's really not that far, but it's kind of a pain to print something off, run out there, grab the sheet, run back, put it on the mat, feed it through the machine, then go back and print another sheet. With this feature, you can print off however many sheets you want and then come back and cut them whenever you want. It doesn't have to be print, cut, print, cut. You can just print them all off and then cut them whenever you'd like. So if you're ready to learn a little bit more about this feature, let's do this. Okay, here we are in Silhouette Studio. I have my sticker designs already brought in. I grabbed this file from Creative Fabrica, and I will drop a link in the description box below. The first thing you always want to do when working in Silhouette is go to your page setup panel and make sure everything is set up properly for the job. I've chosen my machine, the Cameo cutting mat 12 by 12, and letter size paper. My printer is set up for the letter size as well. The next thing I'm going to do is go over to the registration marks tab. That's the third tab on the page setup, and I'm going to turn my registration marks on. I'm also going to come down here and enable barcode on this design. You'll notice that I also have add barcode file to the following library account so that it will sync with my library. Now I'm going to bring my file onto my design mat, and I am going to make sure that all of the hashed areas remain clear and that all of the cut lines are within this red border line. Now, when you're doing a typical print and cut, at this point you would go up to File and Print. But since we are doing the barcode print and cut, we want to go to the Send panel now. I'm going to check that all of my cut lines are lit, and I am going to set my material at this point. I'm going to go with sticker paper white, and I'm going to lower the force just a little bit. Sometimes when I cut sticker paper on this machine, it cuts just a little bit too deep and it makes the stickers hard to peel off. So if I lower my force, it'll cut just a little bit less. Now I'm going to go back to design, and at this point we can go up to File, and print. That's going to bring up the print preview. I always check my print preview before I hit print. All of the registration marks are there. Nothing is cut off. And then we're going to hit print. Now, once you hit print, when you're using the barcode, all of the information for this file is going to be stored. Your cut settings, your cut lines, all of it. It's going to be stored right in this barcode. So you don't want to hit print until you know that everything is exactly the way you want it. Let's print this out. Choose the printer that you're going to be working with. Open up your preferences. Make sure that your document size is the same as it's listed at in Silhouette Studio. When I'm doing stickers, I use plain paper and high quality. Everything looks good there. I'm going to hit OK and then print. Now that I've sent it off to the printer, I am going to close Silhouette Studio completely down. Now that it's shut down, I'm going to go back over and open it up. This step isn't necessary. I just wanted to show you that you can start with a completely clean slate in Silhouette Studio and have this work because of all of the information stored in the barcode. Now, when you want to cut your design, you're going to head over to the Send panel. Notice that my page is completely blank. You do not need anything open to get this done. You're going to prepare your cutting mat. Line up the printed sheet so that it just covers the top left corner of the grid on the mat. Load it into your silhouette just to the right of the white line and close the lid. That helps the sensor read the registration marks in barcode. Then in Silhouette Studio, you're going to go over to this little barcode icon here and click on that. The machine will read the barcode first. Then the registration marks, the blade will adjust to the settings that are saved in the barcode, and then it will start cutting.
I thought I'd pop back on here for just a minute while that's cutting, and we could go over some tips and tricks for print and cut that will help you out. First of all, you want your registration marks to be printed on a matte piece of paper, if at all possible. Now, if you're using glossy sticker paper, you can take just a piece of matte Scotch tape and place them over the registration marks if you're having issues. That'll eliminate some of the glare. If you're using glossy laminate over top of your stickers, you want to cut the corners of the laminate out so that it's not interfering with the registration marks. And you want to close the lid. Outside sources of light throw shadows and can cause the sensor to read the marks wrong, and then your cut is going to be out of alignment. So close the lid, keep the outside lights off, they do not help. If there was one myth that I could debunk, it would be that one for sure. When you are creating your design in Silhouette Studio, you want to make sure that the hashed areas are clean, you want to keep your cut lines within the red border. When you're placing your sheet on the cutting mat itself, you want the upper left-hand corner of the paper to cover the grid just slightly. And when you're loading your mat, you want to place the mat just to the right of the guide on the machine. That little white line, you want the mat to be loaded just to the right-hand side of that. If you follow all of these tips and tricks, your success rate on stickers is going to be awesome. And last but not least, if you found any of this information helpful, if you can hit the thumbs up, I would greatly appreciate it. It helps me out a ton, and it pushes this video out into the YouTube universe so that other crafters can find it as well. Let's go ahead and check the accuracy of the cuts. And there's a nice even border around each of the stickers. It's exactly what you're looking for. That is one of my favorites, 50 Shades of Tired, and also this one. My job is top secret, even I don't know what I'm doing. I do hope that you found that helpful. If you want to learn a little bit more about print and cut, you're going to want to go and watch this video here. If you are done with YouTube for the day, you're going to want to go and create something amazing. And I will see you in the next video.